Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I want to share with you all my polishes for the month of November that I've worn so far. Today is the 13th of November when I'm recording this video, so it's almost halfway through the month. Why don't we start off with the polish that I'm currently wearing on my nails right now. This is OPI in My Italian is a Little Rusty. I had this on my nail polish rack for fall, and I actually wore Diana from Some Call Me Coco. And her video was orange polish collection for fall / Thanksgiving, and I do believe that she talked about this one. And because I knew that I had it on my rack, I decided to just put it on. Now, I put this on, and it does dry way darker than the polish in the bottle. This one reminds me a lot of Essie's Don't Play Coy, but since I just recently destashed that polish a couple of months ago, or a couple of weeks ago, I can't remember when it was, but it's very recent. I don't have it to compare, but it does seem like it's a little bit of a brighter, redder. It's as dark as Don't Play Coy from Essie, but not the same. I wish I had a comparison to show you, but unfortunately I don't. Now, I did add some reverse stamping, and I love the way it came out. I used this plate from Uber Chic, and this is the Hello Fall and Pumpkin Spice number 2. And then I used these two polishes from Wildflower Lacquer for my reverse stamping. This one here is Tweet Heart, and I've used this already twice for reverse stamping. I haven't even used it as a full mani, but I've used it for reverse stamping, and I think it gives me the prettiest orange glow for pumpkins for reverse stamping. Like, holy cow, super impressed. And this one here from Wildflower as well, and this is I Once Played a Nurse on MASH from Up a Creek Volume 5. Oh my god, this beautiful, like, bright olive green polish is so up my alley right now. I'm just going to do a quick comparison since I had it on my desk. This is the Supernatural Lacquer, the Gilman, that I got from HHC September, and they're not the same, which I'm very thankful for, because that's why when I bought this one, I was like, do I really need another olive green polish? But they're not the same, so we're going to go with that. Next, I'm going to talk about another mani that I did for the month of November, and it's this one from Wildflower Lacquer and Ethereal. This here is Virago, and this was a charity polish that Taylor did, the maker of Wildflower Lacquer, did for her cousin, I do believe, who was diagnosed with cancer. Some of the proceeds for this polish is going to go to went to her treatment. And then I added a accent nail of Ophidia, but I do want to mention that with that accent nail, I did do a one layer of Fancy Gloss Got Milk and then two layers of Ophidia, just because I usually wear Ophidia in 3 coats, and I didn't want to use up 3 coats of Ophidia since I haven't found me a backup of Ophidia or a close enough dupe that I do want to try to make this last as long as I can, but still use it up. So I found that this really soft, creamy white, like jelly white, gives this enough saturation without looking weird, because I feel like a cream white was just too much, but this soft, milky, sheer white was perfect as a base for a video. This manicure was actually for a collaboration to welcome Sheila's new baby, and I did not want to take this off. So I actually wore this for about a day and a half, almost 2 days. I thought the combination of these two polishes were so pretty. I did use some stamping images from this Nicole Diary 073 plate, and I used this stamping image right here, and I just thought it looked really pretty. This combination was really pretty. I did end up double stamping the image of the mother and baby, this one right here, because originally I had done all the flowers in white or even frozen from Maniology, and then I wanted to do a dark nail on the white ethereal polish because I didn't think the frozen was going to show up too much on it, and then I didn't like the way that looked, so then I stamped frozen over the dark polish that I used, which I think was Delphinium from Maniology, and I thought it looked better. I kind of wish I would have done that image over all of them, or like that routine over all the rest of the manicure. But all in all, I thought this was a really fun, beautiful mani and a great reason to create it as well. All right, and this is my first manicure that I wore for the month of November, and this is OPI's Never a Dullest Moment. I actually was inspired to wear this manicure because of another video from Diana from Some Call Me Coco, where she was talking about her favorite fall colors or fall yellows, which obviously includes mustard. This is my first mustard polish. This is a super light mustard polish. Like when you compare it with other bright sunny yellows, this definitely leans more mustard, but on its own, it definitely looks like it would be a sunny, summery, or spring yellow, but it really isn't. It's perfect for fall. It even photographs a little bit sunnier than it is in real life. It's very hard to get the proper color for this manicure on film, which is really frustrating because I can never show how really pretty this is. But this is one of my favorite, my first and favorite mustard polish, just because it slowly introduced me to the mustard colors. And then the last polish that I've worn so far for the month of November is OPI's in Linkin Park at Midnight. Oh, I also forgot to say, both of these were the Wear It Again hashtag that I've been trying to do. The Wear It Again hashtag introduced by Forman Phalanges on Instagram, and I wore these again because of that hashtag, and I really have been enjoying that hashtag. Anyways, this is OPI's Linkin Park at Midnight, and Linkin Park at Midnight, it is the sister polish to Linkin Park After Dark, which is a cream, and Linkin Park at Midnight has these beautiful shimmers. Now, the shimmer is not as apparent as it is in the bottle, but it's still there on the nails. In certain lightings, you can definitely see it. So it's not like a flat, dark, almost black cream, which I enjoyed this a lot more because it's not so flat. I tend to think of creams as flat for some reason, like even though sometimes they can appear very flat, most creams that I have tried lately have not given me that effect. I have been enjoying creams a lot more in later years than I did early on when I first started. And this is one of those polishes that I got when I first started wearing nail polish. And this one, it just gives me that vampy, badass feeling with a little bit of kick because of the shimmer than a flat cream does. I also don't remember if I mentioned this in my other video, but this is Passion Fruit Lemonade from Matterhorn Oil, and I finished it in October of this year, and I wanted to make a note of it that I finished another Matterhorn Oil bottle, which to me is a big accomplishment because these things are huge, and I am almost done with a couple more that I have in my collection, so I can't wait until I finish them. Okay, so that is it for part one of my what I wore for November 2021. I actually have not worn any polishes on my toes until the 10th of November. I was actually still wearing this polish here, which is the Cast a Spell from China Glaze that I put on for right before Halloween, I think it was. So that's it for now. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my part two. Bye. Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. So in today's video, I'm going to share with you all the polishes that I wore for the month of November 2021. So the last polish that I wore for November was this one from By Danny Vienna, and this is that name right there. I can't pronounce it. I try every time I look it up. I remember it for like a second and then I forget it. So it looks like it's coming off. Yeah, the sticker looks like it's coming off. I wore this polish because I promised myself that I would get it worn this year. I have had it for about a year. My friend Sheila from Variety Varnish sent this polish to me after she received it in a mystery bag, and she wore it and said that it was nice, but it wasn't for her. And she sent it my way because she knew that I was on the hunt for it since I regretted not getting this when it came out in September of 2020. The red shimmers in this polish definitely stood out on the nails more than in the bottle. Ooh. in the bottle, but I really did enjoy this polish. Before we continue on, I want to let you know what I'm wearing on my nails right now. This is Kathleen and Company, I Don't Say Blah Blah Blah, and this one was actually also gifted to me by my friend Sheila. And this one here is Ugly Christmas Sweater from Taco Lacquer, which unfortunately is no longer being made, but this is my favorite Christmas time glitter that I pull out every year. This next polish was kind of a big disappointment for me. This is KB Shimmer and this is Rise Up. I accidentally got a little bit of acetone on the table where this bottle was resting, so some of the letters came off. But this is Rise Up from KB Shimmer and it is beautiful polish. I still absolutely love it. However, I hated it on me. I hated the way it looked on me. Everything about it was just like, no on my nails, but I still love it. I know that's crazy to say, but it's true. It's still a beautiful polish. I look at it and I'm like, oh my God, this is so pretty. It's so unique. I hate it on my nails. I love it on everybody else but me. It's crazy, but it's true. For Thanksgiving, I wore this polish that I've been wearing for the last couple of years for Thanksgiving. This is OPI in Warm and Fuzzy. This is my absolute favorite OPI for Thanksgiving, my Thanksgiving nails, since it came out in the Muppets collection. It is very well loved. I do need about 3 coats to get this to the opacity that I like. But this year, I decided to revisit my Skittle manicure from last year and change it up just a little bit. I did use a China Glaze in I'm Not Lying as an accent nail. And I also used Wildflower Lacquer, I'm Obsessed With This, which I am. I love these polishes together. I thought they looked really nice last year. I like the manicure that I did this year, not as much as I like the one that I had on last year with these same colors, but it's still a beautiful manicure, Skittle manicure, and perfect for Thanksgiving. One of my early Polish for Days polishes that I purchased, this one is Light Up the Darkness. This is a Black Hearted Beauty custom polish that I purchased way back in 2018, I believe. I've had it in my untried drawers for quite some time, as you can tell, and I decided to bust it out this year, and I am so glad I did. It is so beautiful. In the bottle, I seriously thought it looked exactly like Hawthorne, which I also wore this year. In fact, I wore it before this one, but I'm glad that I actually wore it and realized, no, they do not look alike at all. Speaking of Hawthorne, this is Hawthorne from the Polish for Days Fall Collection. I think it was, oh my God, autumn solstice or something with a solstice in it, I think. I don't know, but I got almost every polish in that collection. That collection completely blew me away from Polish for Days. It's not hard to blow me away with a fall collection though, because I love fall colors. But yes, I wore this and I swear that I thought that these two looked so similar in the bottle, but really, even looking at them in the bottle now, I can definitely tell the difference. But at the time, when I pulled this one out, I still had this on my hands, and I thought, man, this one looks a lot like Hawthorne. But I'm so glad that they don't, so I'm keeping both of them. Another magical polish that I received from MJ Lacquer, and this one is in Autumn. Oh my goodness, this is Autumn in a bottle. The name is absolutely perfection for this polish. It has everything that the autumn leaves have, that the autumn color palette does, and I absolutely loved it. It was such a joy to put this one on and wear it. Next we have Cuticula in Shatter Me. I purchased this back in January, Hella Handmade Creation. In fact, I believe that this is my first Cuticula polish, but before this polish, I only had used the top coat and base coat from this brand. Nothing from them had really appealed to me before this polish, and it was just amazing. This isn't the first Cuticula that I have worn, but this is the first Cuticula that I purchased, like, ever. This is my first Cuticula, and I'm so glad that I actually got it worn now. In fact, I think Polish with Ray actually inspired me to wear this, because she was swatching a polish from Cupcake Polish that was coming out soon, I do believe, for polish pickup for December, if I'm remembering it correctly. And I saw that polish from Cupcake and it immediately made me think of this one, and I decided to bring it out. I already had it in my fall rack and I knew that I wanted to wear it, so why not wear it now? Now, this polish from Bees Knees Lacquer is a PR polish. I received this for swatching. This one is, she was respawning it in her last collection, and I wore this and fell in love with this polish. So hard. I mean, like, so hard. It was so beautiful. Now, it did stain me, surprisingly. I didn't expect a color this light to stain me, but it did. But it's okay because I wear polish all the time. It doesn't really bug me that much. But this one was such a beautiful, beautiful color. So that's it. Those are all the polishes that I wore for the month of November. This is the part two. I'm sure that the part one is already up at the front. Thank you everyone for taking the time to watch my videos. I really appreciate your support. Leave me a comment down below and let me know if you wore any of the same polishes that I wore, or what did you wear that was very fall-esque to you. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!